Hey guys, welcome back to another video. So in today's video we would be understanding about the custom permissions in Salesforce. So if you are not having any idea, or if you are having just a vague idea of what are custom permissions and where they are used, so this video would be a guiding path in understanding the scenarios, right? So if you see a custom permission, it is a control mechanism for your custom functionality, right? We know we have profiles, we have permission sets also. Then why is there is a need of custom permissions, right? Because every time when we are working on the functionality, we generally think of all the trade-offs, that what could be the best possible way so that we could make use of the platform to its maximum potential, right? So in that terms, custom permissions also helps you in defining out things that you are not in capable of doing via permission sets or profiles, or you could say that it is an add-on to your profiles as well as permission sets. So let's learn about this. So if you go to your object manager and if you type in custom permissions, this custom permission page opens, and in here you could create a new custom permission. And what are the details required? This the name, label, you could specify the connected app also, like, and whether this should be a protected component or not. Okay, so just some simple details. So if you don't want to add a connected app also, you could just start with the name only, and other details are not eventually necessary. Now let's move further. So now let's just talk about the scenarios where we use our custom permissions. So the first scenario here is your formulas and validation rules. Now let's say you have users who don't have a particular permission, and if they don't have a particular permission, so they should not be allowed to edit a particular field, correct? Now you could say that we could have what we could have done is we have profiles and we have permission sets. So on the profile level, what we could have done is we could have removed the access. We should not have given the access to that field, and via permission set we could have given the access to the fields to those users, right? And that is also a correct way, but is it a more optimized way or is it a more accurate way? Let's see with this scenario. So we have two users with the same profile, and generally guys, whenever you would be working in your client, with your client orgs and or any other project for that matter, in maximum of the time you would be having certain restrictions. It would not be that okay, you are just taking out things and working on that, creating profiles, creating permissions. That's no, we have a limitation because everything costs to the business. So business generally prefers where you put in less cost and you could derive out more profits, correct? Now let's go with this scenario. In this scenario, and this scenario I would try to relate to as much as it is to your real life. So we have two users with the same profile, right? And where we want one user to edit that field while other users should not edit that field. So in this scenario, our profile and permission set could have been a better approach, right? If we see from this till here, right? Ideally, what we could have done is we could have different profiles. First solution is we could have different profiles for these users, and or from here our second condition starts, that we could have one profile and multiple permission sets, right? But the scenario here is you cannot create a permission set. So what are we left with? Any other approach if you are having? So we are gonna go with your custom permissions. And now in order to create a custom field or reference that custom permission in your validation rule, is you would use this function, or you would use this permission, dollar permission, and this is the name of your custom permission, right? So you could have this any particular business name as per your business standards, right? So that is the syntax for this. So from here, what we could understood here is, if we have a limitation on the number of fields, profiles or permission sets, then we could definitely try out a way that if we want to bypass this, or if we want to give a particular access to particular set of users only, we should try going with your custom permissions, right? Because that is out of the box functionality, and profile permission sets would cost you in that matter if you haven't utilized the custom permissions, right? Now another example is your lightning page filters. Now again, we have a scenario here that we have two teams with the same profile, right? And for the account record page, you just want to edit something, right? What we need is, however, we need to limit or show a specific subset of fields. Okay, so let's say we have two profiles, profile A and profile B. For profile A, we want to display 50 fields, and profile B, we just want to display those 10 fields. We are having same profile, guys, sorry. So these are team A and team B, not profile A and profile B, sorry for that. So both of these, we have just the same profile, and page layout works on the profile level, as we know. So how we would be able to achieve this is, like, we could go to the page, we could edit that page. Probably by now most of the organization have updated their fields to your dynamic actions. So we are assuming that dynamic actions are enabled, and over that, what we could do is, we could set a filter for individual fields. If your dynamic field actions are not even enabled, what we could do is, we could just add a filter stating the component visibility. So what am I exactly saying here is, for now we have example for our opportunity layout. What we are doing is, we edited the page, and in here, if you see this set component visibility, right? And in the advanced section, we have the option for your operator, field and value, right? So what we could do is, we could select the field. So we could select the type, that which permission we want to include in here. So let's say we have the permission test, then only that particular section should be visible, else that section should not be visible. So we could use your custom permissions in this scenario also. Moving further, we can use your custom permission in flows as well as your apex classes, right? Till now you have used in validation rules, right? And page layouts, or what you could say is record pages, right? Or lightning pages. Now you could utilize this field in flows also, because since you could use this in validation rules, we have the syntax for flows also. Now in apex classes also, we could use this functionality. Now how you could use this functionality is via the use of a feature management class. So what does this do is, this feature management class has a method called check permission, and it checks for your custom permission, okay? And it checks whether we have that particular permission enabled, where we have this where we would be adding the API name for the custom permission that we would define. If we have the permission, we could carry out the operation, else we could have another pathway, right? So this was the advantage of your custom permission. So whatever we understood here was validation rules. Most probably you would see this in your in any organization, you would be using this in your validation rules as well as flows also to that extent. But apex, like, probably it was used a long way back when we have the era of your VF pages, right? But now, since we have moved and migrated to your LWC LWR sites, so this trend has been changed a little bit. So generally we don't use that much VF, so most probably you would be seeing this in your validation rules, and you would be utilizing that there. So I hope this was a educational session that brainstormed your thinking process, how you could think from a technical perspective to that of a end developer perspective, so you understood the entire flow, how it should be, where it should be, and why it should be. I hope this video meant a difference in your lives. So if that is it, do like, share, and subscribe this video, and do check out our other videos also. Thanks for watching and have a great day.